Hi everyone, welcome to my channel and welcome to the second video of my ARC 101 series. Today I'm going to be talking about using and understanding scales, and I'll make a quick demonstration on how I take a drawing from Rhino 6 and export it into Illustrator for printing. This subject matter is integral to the understanding of architecture and the application in academic and in career life, so I will try to be as clear and descriptive as possible. So without further ado, let's begin. So in architecture, scales are used to represent full-size designs in a smaller or sometimes enhanced format. And depending on what country you're from, they will use either the metric or the empirical scale. For instance, I did my undergrad in Canada, so I was taught to use the metric scale all through undergrad. And then once I moved to America to study for my graduate degree, and while I was working in American companies, we had to use the empirical scale. So switching between the two was a little bit difficult for me, but eventually you start to recognize certain ratios that are actually equivalent. So one thing I will say that makes the metric and the empirical system different is the following. The metric system has many small units, so the millimeter, the centimeter, the decimeter, to describe values that are a fraction of the conventional construction unit, which is the meter. The empirical system has one unit, the inch, that's a fraction of the conventional construction unit, the foot. And so it has to be continually divided in order to get a value that is smaller than an inch. So for instance, 1 millimeter is equal to 0.0393 blah, 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 inches, or 3/64 inches. So making those equivalencies are a little bit difficult, especially when you have to start using decimals, but that's essentially what makes the metric and empirical system a little bit different and a little bit tricky to use. So let's first look at the empirical scale. And there are four different ways to represent a scaled model or drawing. The first is the graphical method, so that's either using a scale bar or to use a line that represents a certain distance. And this is to allow somebody to physically walk up to your model or drawing with a ruler and measure a certain distance, say 1 inch, and be able to understand that, okay, 1 inch is equal to X amount of feet in real life. Here I have some examples using a scale bar. The great thing is that no matter what size you would print a drawing out in, as long as the proportions in the drawing stay the same, the measurements will be accurate. A scale factor represents the relationship of size between your drawing or model and real life. So this is read as 1:48 or 1/48. A fractional scale takes two measurements of different units and relates them to each other. So you see on the left side, we're using 1/4 or 1/4 inch, and the right side shows 1 foot. And the decimal scale describes the same thing, but is read as 0.25 inch or 0.25 inch to a foot. Again, when using scales, you have to make note of the units. So again, on the left side, we have 1/4 inch, and on the right side, we have a foot. But this means that the drawing is 1/48 of the true size. Now, where did we get our 1/48 from? Remember that a scale factor of 1:48 represents the same unit. So in order to understand that 1/4 inch equals 1 foot is 1/48 the true size, we have to make 1/4 inch the same unit as 1 foot. It sounds a little bit complicated, but it's very straightforward. To do that, we work with the left side, start by converting the 1/4 inch to 1 inch by multiplying it by 4. Next, we take our inch and convert it to feet by multiplying by 12, because we know that there are 12 inches in a foot. So in all, we took our fraction, 1/4 inch, multiplied it by 4, then again by 12, and we get our foot measurement. And we know that 12 times 4 is 48. This is the same thought process using any of the other conventional scales. For example, 1/8 inch, which is 1/96 the true size, and 1/2 inch, which is 1/24 the true size. Now let's talk metric. And metric, in my opinion, is a little bit simpler because, as I described before, we already have names for units that are a fraction of what metric countries commonly use in construction, the meter. The metric scale can be graphical, where again, you should be able to go up to your model or drawing and measure the proportions accurately. It could be measured as a scale factor, and it could also be measured as equivalencies of, for example, 1 centimeter to 1 meter. Again, the scale factor describes two distances at the same unit, where the left side means the measurement in the drawing or model, and the right side means its measurement in real life. For example, this reads 1 to 100 or 1 100th scale, right? So I should be able to take a ruler up to a drawing or model and say, hey, this wall measures 4.5 centimeters, and at 1 100th scale, this means that the wall is actually 4.5 meters. Why 1 to 100? It's easy. Remember that there are 100 centimeters in a meter. So a scale that is 1 to 100 or 1 100th the size means that every 1 centimeter represented in the model or drawing is 1 meter or 100 centimeters in real life. This works for centimeters, millimeters, and decimeters, although decimeters aren't conventionally used in architectural drawings or models. But essentially, it's the same thing. In the case of a millimeter, there are 10 millimeters in a centimeter and 10 centimeters in a meter. So we divide the scale by 10, which gives us 1 to 1,000 or 1 1,000th of the size. So now I'll do a quick export demo where I take a drawing that I'm working on in Rhino 6 and export it to Illustrator so I can modify and then print out. I'll preface it by saying you don't always have to export to another program in order to print. You can print straight from Rhino 6 or Rhino 5 or any earlier versions. And that's a bunch of steps that I can't talk about in this video. But in order to make any modifications, certain things that you can't do in Rhino, you export it to Illustrator like I like to do. For simplicity's sake, and because I'm just used to it now, I'm going to be using the empirical scale, but I'll mention how to do it with the metric scale. It's the same thing. So I need to take this section of a model that measures about 30 by 11 feet, or roughly 9.35 meters, and scale it so that it can fit on an 11 by 17 piece of paper. 11 by 17 is a typical architectural drawing paper size. The easiest thing I can do is to do some quick maths. So knowing that the longest measurement is 30 feet, and that needs to fit in 11 inches, what I can do is I can convert 30 feet into inches by multiplying it by 12, because again, there are 12 inches in a foot, then divide it by 17 so that it perfectly fits onto the page. The number I get is 21.17. That is the scale factor that I would need to use for the drawing to fit perfectly onto the page. But there's two problems. One is that you never really want your drawing to fit perfectly. You always want a little bit of wiggle room. And number two, the scale factor is not conventional. So ideally, we would want to use a scale factor that's slightly smaller. Luckily, a 1 to 24 scale factor, or half inch to 1 foot scale, is smaller than a 1 to 21.17 scale factor. So we'll use that. So what we do is highlight our drawing, click export, and we get the options tab. What is our model scale? We see that the left side has a blank and says foot, and the right side has a blank and says inches. Make sure if you're using a scale that is inches to foot, these things say inches to foot, not inches to meters, etc., etc. Using our chosen scale, half inch to a foot, we put 1 foot on the left side and 0.5 inches on the right side. Then when we export, we see here that the drawing fits lovely into a position on the page, and we double check the paper size, and yeah, it measures 11 by 17. If we were using the metric scale, we would do the same thing. Figure out what the appropriate scale factor is to fit the 43 centimeter page. A 1 to 20 scale factor would fit it perfectly and is a conventional scale, but the next scale is 1 to 50, which would make the drawing very small. So it really depends on what's asked of you and what's appropriate to be able to see in the drawing. And that is it for scales. As I said, it is a quick and easy video. I hope I was as clear and concise as possible, but this is information that's important to you studying architecture or working in the architectural profession for the rest of your life. The same thought process applies for when you're enlarging something. So say you're doing a detailed drawing or a sectional drawing and you want to enlarge a certain view, you do a scale that is, for example, 3 inch to a foot or 4 inch to a foot. But thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned for more videos in this series, and I hope you have a wonderful day.
I'm wondering what all this noise is coming from. Is this culprit right here? Hey!